Hi, I am Manjot from Lenspassions Photography. Today I will discuss about new texture slider. The new non-destructive texture slider available both in Lightroom Classic as well as Lightroom CC version. It also available in Photoshop by using camera raw filter. So open Photoshop and then open new image in Photoshop workspace. You can find camera raw filter by simply go to filter menu and select camera raw filter. The new texture slider resides above the clarity slider. Moving the texture slider to the left will reduce unwanted medium sized details to smoothing the skin texture. While moving the texture slider to the right enhances medium sized details in photograph to increase the texture of foliage or hair. You can also do the same Lightroom CC version. You can now smoothen or accentuate details such as skin, bark and hair with the new texture slider. You can adjust the texture slider negatively to smooth skin and retain fine pore details to ensure natural looking skin. You can increase the texture amount to accentuate the details such as bark or hair without affecting less detailed areas. Like the out of focus area in photograph, adjusting the texture slider does not change the color or tonality in your photograph. It is also same in Lightroom Classic. For those of you who spend more time adjusting the actual frequencies in an image, either through the use of frequency separation or other frequency modifications, this new slider might come in particularly handy for you. First, have a look at the difference between the original image and image with the clarity set to 100. Here is the original image compared with texture set to 100. Now texture and clarity setting compared, both are set to 100. As you can see in the images, the clarity slider in Lightroom darkens contrasty image area, reduces the color saturation and slightly bleeds over the edges. The texture slider improves the contrast in the area and does not affect surrounding areas. Now the original images versus the images with the clarity set to -100. The same with original image versus texture set to -100. A comparison between clarity and textures both set to -100. By using both -100, smoothing the texture slider almost delivers a oil painting like a look. In the result, the clarity setting was always good to enhance a dramatic sky. And for skin, hairs and other details, happy to use the new texture settings as the result look really pleasing your eyes. Here I have zoomed in a bit to show the effect of negative texture. Note how the eyelashes, pore details and other natural skin characteristics remain even as the skin is softened. Texture is available as both a global slider and a local adjustment. We were able to get good result in the last example with just global texture. But let's look at the using local texture in the photo. We don't want to use just negative texture in smooth things. We definitely want to keep the texture in model here. So we will use two different selection brushes. The first to apply negative textures to her skin and the second to add textures to her hair, ear and lips. So I selected a new brush for negative texture. First, reset the sliders to default. When you click on the center of slider, the slider moved to zero value. I increase the exposure first to highlight the area that I want to soft. After selecting the area, I again set exposure value to zero with active brush tool. So any change will be made affect only this area in non-destructive way. I am moving slider to -69, it's okay for me, and check the skin area that I want to soft by clicking overlay mask. After that, I selected new brush and reset the slider value to 0 and increase exposure value to highlight that area where I want to emphasize the texture details, like hair, lips and eyebrows. After selecting the area, again reset the exposure value to 0 and set texture slider to 100. Watch the difference before and after. Texture applied using adjustment brush, set to negative value to soften skin and to positive value to enhance eyes and hair. The user who like to workshop in Photoshop, they can also do in camera raw filter with same way as well as with layers. Especially where use slider globally and use masking layer to reveal original details in non-destructive way. Opening same picture in Photoshop workspace. Creating duplicate layer by Ctrl plus J in Windows and Command plus J in Mac. After that, convert the layer as a small object by going Layer Panel menu and select Convert Small Object. By using this, it performs non-destructive transforms. You can make any modification to layer without losing original image data or quality because the transforms don't affect the original data. So here it performs non-destructive filtering. You can edit filters applied to smart object at any time. So go to filter menu and then select camera raw filter. Texture filter resides above the clarity slider. I set negative value to -71 and applied it globally and click OK. In Photoshop workspace, you can see the every part of the image turned to smooth. So select the white mask and use D key for foreground white or black. Use S key to toggle foreground white to black. Make sure your foreground color is opposite to the color of the mask. If you are painting with black on white mask, the content of the part of layer is becoming transparent, while the white part remains as is. So I am painting on white with black brush to reveal the original details of the eyes, lips and hair. Just reminding you, kindly support my channel by click on subscribe button and click on the bell so you will be notified when I will upload a new video. See the change. According to me, it is the best tool of 2019 to smoothing or increasing the texture details. Do you like this tool or not? Kindly share with me and also comment. Thanks for watching.